This is another attempt at recording a video podcast, or maybe just the audio. Who knows how that'll turn out. I've done this several times, and I don't necessarily have a sequence. These are basically ongoing discussions about consciousness and what that means and what the implications are as you delve into those questions. And as is probably going to be the case with most of these, I'm going to smoke a blunt throughout the duration. I could take that in a lot of different directions, but just the kind of mission statement of what I'm doing is basically looking at life through the lens of this is a conscious experience, or at the very least, if it is a purely materialistic experience, you're partaking of it through your consciousness, so why not be focused on improving the quality of your consciousness? And so that's kind of the lens through which I'm looking at just everyday life stuff or big philosophical ideas, and everything in between. And so looking at the idea that consciousness is your primary focus, and I guess I'll go with the more metaphysical meaning that it's not just how you perceive the world, it is the world, that it comes first. That's an idea that not necessarily everybody would subscribe to, so I'm possibly leaving large swaths of people out by looking at things through that lens, but that's the point of sharing this, is like, what do you do with your life if you're looking at reality as though it's a almost like a dream, a conscious experience that you're living out some sort of drama or story? So with that in mind, you know, how do you filter your everyday decisions through that idea? So my general direction with that is to try to look at being always working on myself towards being more loving, and loving myself and loving other people, even people who are not necessarily all that nice to you, because life can definitely throw some pretty fucked up situations at you and people who will do fucked up things. And there's a real big emphasis, I think, on knowing who you look at as like a bad person, and categorizing certain people as bad people, and making them off limits to your life, and putting up walls, which those walls can be important. Boundaries are important. Maintaining boundaries is your responsibility as a person, basically. But the idea is you don't necessarily have to take those bad experiences and the hard feelings that you generally have from those and take it forward with you into all the next stages of your life. The idea that the onus is on you to let go of the things that you're carrying around in terms of like hard feelings towards people who've done fucked up shit to you. So if you are looking at things in the direction of being loving, it's got to include people who are fucking assholes. And what do you do with that? Like, and why? That's a big question too. Probably people who are exposed to that idea who don't necessarily see even the importance of forgiving people or letting go would even ask why. Why even bother? And I would say the biggest reason is that because, again, it's the quality of your own consciousness. It's the baggage that you want to carry forward, the filter or the fogginess on the lens of how you view reality. It's going to be shittier if you're always thinking about how everyone's out to fuck you over, or thinking about the people who have. It's not really a good way to live, and it tends to manifest some pretty shitty stuff. So basically what I want to do is repeatedly go through different experiences that I have, trying to forgive people and forgive myself, because it's a constant running challenge. I mean, it's like every day is some new brush with letting go of bullshit, of baggage. I could choose any number of directions to take that in, but I would say probably the most challenging would be family, you know, relationships. You could go easy and look at less intimate attachments that you have with people, because I think it's easy to brush off coworkers or if you have hobbies, music or whatever, you see people on a regular basis, but you're maybe not friends or family. They might be an easy place to start in terms of practicing a little bit of forgiveness when they rub you the wrong way. Before you move on to the major stuff, like forgiving your parents for whatever they did to fuck you up. So it's not easy. But yeah, starting small, probably the best step. I'm going to be doing this a lot, so I'm not going to necessarily do them in any particular order, so I'm going to jump into family. I think it's easy to look at your, I'm talking like the fa your family of origin, not necessarily if you're the, parents of children or raising siblings or something like that, but like starting early. That kind of environment, obviously, you just arrive in a situation and you don't really know. You didn't get to pick your family, so that you don't really. It's almost like you can hold a lot against them because you're just kind of thrust into this situation with them. And if they act shitty, it's like you can't look at it from the point of view that you asked for that. You were just born into it.
Well, that point of view, I think, promotes the idea that you don't need to forgive them if they really fuck up. They really scar you.
Because you didn't ask to be born in that family. Like, that's, I think that's an easy out. So, if you're looking through the lens that this is a conscious experience, you might also be considering the idea that we do this more than once, that, we do this to experience things and that we go through cycles, that we reincarnate. You don't have to tie it down to that word if that bothers you. But the idea that if you are manifesting a conscious experience, if you're going in that direction, seems to make sense that you would do it a lot. If it were a video game, why would you just play once? So with that in mind, you may actually have some involvement in the family that you are born into. It's a point of view that some people would dismiss from a more Western point of view, but I think from, more Eastern point of view, something that just takes reincarnation for granted. Obviously, you could find a little bit more exploration of that idea. New Age, obviously, that's it abounds. But with that in mind, you might look at the challenges you're having with your family and think, well, what am I trying to learn from this if I really did set up these kind of experiences for myself before I incarnated and am now dealing with those decisions? Like, what did maybe I bit off more than I could chew, and now I'm dealing with this shitty kind of thing that I painted myself into a corner and my life sucks and I'm powerless to change it. It's like that's. I can see how you could easily get disempowered by a shitty family situation, but if you can also look at it as a challenge that you chose to take on, that really enables you to like really choose ways that you could do something about it. That's kind of the thing that I came around to when I started learning about first like Buddhism and Hinduism and things like that, and then a little bit more of the it's like open form spirituality, because I hate the term New Age. I mean, I really it encompasses a lot that I it puts a bad taste in my mouth, but it, something like the book, Your Soul's Gift by Robert Schwartz, which is just a book about his series of past life regressions that people would do, and he would do like case studies of their past life regressions, which. Whether you believe in past lives or not, it's an interesting line of inquiry. If you ever take the time to listen to a past life regression session, which there are lots on YouTube, they're like an hour and a half, 2 hours long, so you gotta kind of sit through it. But people paint really vivid stories of lives that they've lived, and you could be skeptical about it and say that they're just kind of making it up or they're summoning it out of their subconscious. But even if that's true, the content that's coming out of those sessions is really fascinating, and it can be pretty mind-bending. My point in that being, if you read a book like Your Soul's Gift or Your Soul's Plan, I might be mistaken on the name, but Robert Schwartz is the author. But if you read through those, it's just constantly recurring theme of lessons. Like you're taking on hard things because there is something you wanted to learn. And so it really enables you to take on difficult situations with family. So, like in my own case, Like with my parents, I'm generally pretty grateful to my parents. I think they did the best they could, and also being a parent, I used to dismiss that phrase, they did the best they could, because people with really shitty track records sometimes get off the hook because they did the best they could, and it's like it almost feels like there's real injustice in that phrase. But that being said, being a dad now and seeing what my parents went through, even just having a 3-year-old and an 8-month-old, it gave me a new appreciation of, like, yeah, people are doing the best they can, because we live in an insane world. We structure our ways of raising kids in an insane way that doesn't make sense. But anyway, looking at it through that lens, that I might have chose a set of parents that had some setbacks that would have channeled me into a life experience that I would have had something to learn from, like, that gave me a lot of room to let go of the baggage of, like, thinking that, you know, my dad fell short in this way or my mom fell short in this way. You know, me, like, I wish my dad would have been more involved. He was really like a tired parent, and you know, I was the fourth kid, and it showed that he was just kind of worn down and resisting the whole situation because he wasn't finding ways to find joy in his day-to-day life. And I'm learning from that now because I'm being challenged in that very same way. Like, I have kids that demand so much of my time that it's difficult to eke out time to do anything. I mean, recording this is a kind of creative expression. It's taken a long time to just carve out time to do that. And it's not necessarily that you don't have the minutes in the day, it's that you don't have the will to do it, you know, because of the volume of things that you had to use your sense of, hey, you know, let's get this done. Like, I mean, it is really incredibly, where's he thin? It's daunting, but and also very rewarding if I were to try to balance the scale on the other side to not make that too one-sided. But my point being, you know, with a consciousness kind of oriented point of view, a reincarnational point of view, you can have shitty parents that you might wonder what did they set about doing with their life in terms of their lessons, and how is that intersecting with my lessons, and am I getting something out of this, or at least should I try to get something out of this? So that is something that I would just implore people to explore, is the idea that there is something built into their hardships that they can extract if they really choose to. And a big part of it is letting go of the hard feelings you have for other people, but also for yourself, because that shit will really tie you up if you won't forgive yourself for things you've done wrong. And it's not easy, but it is something that when you set about doing it for small things, just like working out a muscle, you can gradually increase the load that you can carry in terms of letting go of self-judgment, of, you know, being your own worst critic. And it feels great. I mean, it's like I'm again likening it to working out, but it is like working out and seeing yourself lose weight progressively. It takes time, but if you set about your intention to forgive yourself and not let your mistakes define you and let them drag you down, it's very liberating. Difficult with family, that's like the top of the list as far as like the hardest. I've given the example of getting criticized at work and feeling like I could just experience that without letting it drag my sense of self down. But when it's like stuff at home, whether it's my parents and sisters or my wife and children, it's way, way more daunting to let go of your mistakes because there's so much more pressure you put on yourself to be a good family member. And society, it feels like the whole world watches you. It's a weird thing, but in a way, it feels like you're always under everyone's scrutiny when it comes to how you're making decisions, even if it's just the sense that something you may do at home may eventually be repeated to somebody else, or somebody, you know, just depending on circumstances, may find out about something you did. And it is just kind of always this weird sense that, like, you're being judged for how you raise your kids or how you perform as a employee, or, you know, whatever it is. Like, we set these crazy standards for ourselves, and we easily make ourselves feel disempowered and like a piece of shit because we failed in some way. But I'm gonna wrap this up because it's getting close to 15 minutes. But yeah, biggest point of all is let go of your mistakes without necessarily letting go of responsibility, but just let go of the feeling of being a shitty person who's not capable of doing good, like that sense, just let that go. Realize you made a mistake, but that you're still an amazing person who has all these awesome things to offer underneath your baggage that you're clearing out. So, with that, I will wish you a good day.